quarter.
Oh, there's a goal!
The trade deadline in the NHL is come and gone, so why not begin with the Blues? Because it seems like they deserve that right. Not just for last year's success, but with the prolonged winning streak they've been on to reassert their claim on the Central Division. They mostly stood pat, only acquiring Marco Scandella for an overpayment of sorts, but they were in a bind. Jay Bouwmeester, all I'm going to say is thank God he's okay. Shades of Yuri Fisher with what happened to him. I only wish him health and success in his future.
Are you ready, Raleigh? We're panic buying like there's a hurricane warning. Fuck the pundits, we have the pieces to go far in the playoffs. Why care about future assets when the future is now? Look at the new talents we've gotten at the deadline. Vinny Trocheck, Sammy Vatanen, and Brady's... We might be out of a playoff spot now, but our assets are going to take us over the top. Our goaltending is in critical condition. Someone get that Zamboni driver back. Please, someone stop a goddamn puck from getting in the net. Please, God, save the Hurricanes.
With the moves and potential deals made by the Islanders as of late, I can say one thing. Lou Lamoriello has seemingly lost his mind. It doesn't really have to do with the trade for Jean-Gabriel Pageau. Although the price was rather staggering for his services, extending him immediately eases the sting of such a cost. Especially if he maintains his form for most of the contract. No, the real question isn't trying to trade for Zach Parise. It's not the player that's the problem, but the terrible deal he'll be on for the next 5 years. The ashes of Andrew Ladd would have gone the other way, but so would several significant futures. Both players waived their no-trade clauses for the deals, and the hockey world was abuzz. The only problem was that the trade never went through. Mikko Koivu was supposed to move as well in this deal, and he refused to waive his no-trade clause. It would not be shocking if they revisit this in the summer. Although Minnesota's fancying themselves as something better than playoff fodder, so who the hell knows. Jim Rutherford witnesses the Penguins and still has that itch. It is the eternal unrest of the old man. He must make trades to keep the team fresh. Pittsburgh may be overachieving, but they can always be better. JR knows what they need. A dad of the team. Matt Cullen was perfect in this role, and they're hoping the answer is in Patrick Marleau. I did not see him in a Penguins uniform, not going to lie. They'll squeeze the last of whatever ability has left in the hopes of getting him a cup. He will not be alone. With Gensel's injury, they need a new wingman for Crosby. That man is Jason Zucker. Analytics love him, and JR loved him so much that he paid a very steep price for him via trade. Was Galchenyuk that much of a deadweight? Also, for some reason, Connor Sherry is back in town. Isn't he a bit redundant? Even if he did come with a struggling Evan Rodriguez, why did they trade Dominic Cahoon? Seems like a move for the sake of making a move. Unfortunately, that may not be enough to save the Pens from playing like shit as of late. God damn it. Blue Jackets, did you like the injuries? I have some good news for you boys. The entire team has been infected with hockey's version of the bubonic plague. That bubble of winning was pretty nice, wasn't it? Know what happens when you soar too high? Well, now you get to fall to your deaths. There is no help coming to this team besides a minor move or two. You're on your own. The hordes of dead are piling in the locker room. At least you have an excuse if you don't make it. Philadelphia has done the exact opposite. They've found the next step towards realizing their potential. A winning streak and accompanying offensive touch have given the Flyers a shot at once was almost unthinkable. The Metro Division lead. To do this, they didn't do anything outstanding but depth moves to get Derek Grant and Nate Thompson to shore up the bottom six. See the good that happens when you have goaltending, boys? You get a shot at something more. There are times when the plans can change course. Unexpected winning or losing can do that to a specific franchise. In this case, the Rangers on a torrid winning streak will change such actions. The goal was to sell off assets for the future, but maybe it's closer than it looks. Especially with the emergence of Igor Shesterkin in net, things are looking optimistic. Good enough to not only hold on to Chris Kreider, but sign him to a lengthy extension. Fair value, lengthy term. Even then, they still sold a bit. Brady Shea is gone, leaving some Rangers fans puzzled and some cheering since he allegedly sucked. They won't be cheering anymore since there was a car accident involving Pavel Buchnevich in the aforementioned Shesterkin. Igor will be out for a few weeks, but at least it's nothing major. Carry on. A milestone has just been reached. Alex Ovechkin has scored 700 goals in the NHL. A truly Herculean effort. It may have been a bit longer than expected, and the Capitals have been pretty bad as of late, but Ovechkin continues to forge his legacy. One new twist to the team, even with being near the cap, is Ilya Kovalchuk. Brought in to solidify the middle six and the power play for a third-round pick. An interesting buy, and for those of you who wanted Kovi and Ovi on the same team, here's your chance. Kovalchuk isn't the same player, but he can still be of use. If he's used properly, I mean. Just get out of that funk you're in, yeah? I must say, I still have no clue what Buffalo is doing. They go through these peaks and dips like a roller coaster. One moment they look like shit, the next they dominate their opposition. Even with all the elements against them, Buffalo is desperate to make the playoffs. They are buying at the deadline. A lateral move to get Dominic Cahoon in trade for Wayne Simmons. You do realize Simmons is nowhere near the player he was, right? I hope you do something with yourselves for your fans' sake, but I'm just not seeing it. Once again, a losing culture is tough to overcome. The Sabres are proof of that. Tampa Bay knows that their goals for the season lie in the playoffs, and they are at least doing something to bolster up for another push that will hopefully last longer than 4 games. The prices were exorbitant for bottom six help. A first-round pick and a top prospect for Blake Coleman. A premium, but Coleman is a very good player who should make an immediate impact. They also traded a first-round pick for, let me get this right, Barclay Goodrow? You traded a first for a fourth liner who hasn't scored more than 10 goals in a season? I mean, at least you got a third-round pick back, but he better be the best damn fourth liner ever to justify the price tag. Beantown is cruising along, but like many in the NHL, the arms race guides them to add more quality. They went to one main destination for their upgrades, Anaheim. Hoping that Nick Ritchie can turn the corner and realize his potential, and an interesting acquisition for Andre Kasha. Great player when he's healthy. That's the key, though. When he's healthy. Tampa's gaining fast, so we can only hope you can maintain pace. Or else you'll have to face these boys again. Toronto. Oh, God. What the hell is going on? Weren't you supposed to be a lot better than this before the season? If that's the case, then why the hell are you losing games to a 42-year-old Zamboni driver? Who works for the Maple Leafs? On your own ice. You've been dunked on all season and for good reason. The money poured into the forward core has cost the team on defense and in net. They tried to solve backup goaltender with trading for Jack Campbell, at least. What else happened? Not much of anything. They awkwardly stood pat or made smaller transactions when they needed to make bigger moves. I would say at least you extended Muzzin, but he's out long term now. No, shut up, Toronto, you are not firing Kyle Dubas. That is stupidity at this point in time. There's still plenty of time to fix this, but yeah, it's gonna take a lot to do so. Montreal's delusional, get them out of here. Not selling much of anything yet, believing they're still a quality team, despite injuries and underperformance. No, Bergevin, your team just isn't good enough. Stop blaming the players when you put them in situations to fail. Why should the Canadiens care? They still sell out games. They're good on the financial end. Bitterly staring inside the window where all the popular hockey teams are playing with playoff toys, the Florida Panthers sulk in the rain. They are always on the outside looking in. It's mistake after mistake after mistake. Bobrovsky's contract looked ghastly at the time of signing, and now? Oh dear God. Now what's this I'm hearing, that Florida wants to cut payroll again? Isn't your goal to make the playoffs? Trocheck is gone, but why didn't you get any help on defense? That was one of your main problems. Once again, self-inflicted wounds for a team that should be more. If I'm Dale Tallon, I'd consider seeking other employment. Edmonton is still alive and kicking, eh? Not bad. And they're choosing to address their issues in team depth to give them more offensive diversity. Good. Sure, it's mostly for Ken Holland's old pets in Detroit, but it's better than nothing. Tyler Ennis is doing well and only cost them a fifth round pick. A burner like Athanasiou might do wonders for the middle six. Well, that was until he got injured. Same as Mike Green. Sorry, Oilers, you can have nothing good in this world. The internet is buzzing with fervor. Johnny Hockey has left the practice rink early. Think of the blockbusters that could be made with such a piece dangling. Unfortunately, the only dangling was in front of a urinal. He had to tinkle. False alarm. You did get some defensemen, though. Next topic. This is Vancouver's time to shine. They are ready for a playoff push. Ignore this Brock Besser injury, that's not important. They've got Tyler Toffoli to replace him. He's good, and he didn't cost the Canucks their soul to get. There is, however, the issue of Jacob Markstrom. He's gonna be out for a bit. For insurance, you get Louis Domingue. Exhilarating, I know. Vegas seems to have gotten their shit together. Or is that just the rest of the Pacific still stumbling over themselves? I can't tell. Their biggest question moving forward was in the net. They needed a legit substitute so they didn't burn out Fleury again. They accomplished this goal with Robin Lehner. A rental, but a solid get at good value. There's also Alec Martinez, who was acquired at a bit of a steeper price. Should be good for the defense, though, right? It will only help for them to do this with the pace they're going at, yes? Throughout the Windy City, thousands of bitter Blackhawks fans clamor to an empty chamber to demand the firing of Stan Bowman. I don't blame them for doing this. In my uneducated, humble opinion, they should have gotten much more for Gustafson and Lehner. Vegas needed a real option to relieve Fleury, and you only got a second roster filler and a long-shot prospect? A third-round pick for one of the better defensemen on the market? I guess it's better than nothing, but... The Avs are still cruising along with certain elements starting to step up, but Sakic felt like the team didn't need too much. It was mainly minor acquisitions for them. Vladislav Namestnikov for the bottom six and Michael Hutchinson. who will hopefully never see the light of day. Toronto can warn you about that firsthand. That's worst case scenario, though. I know this tweet is supposed to be a joke, but did Nashville even try? I mean, they probably did, but they're still in a playoff race. You'd think they'd try to get a defenseman or two to shore up. Oh well, still think you can make it, Minnesota. Even with finally casting off Jason Zucker after relentless trade rumors. What are you going to do once you make it there? Be happy since you told the barbecue man to wipe himself with a pink slip? Sorry, but I don't buy their foolish ambitions. Seems like good fodder for Bruce's next feast? Maybe? Even Winnipeg is still within striking distance, but they really didn't do much at the deadline either. Just Dylan DeMello for a rather low price. I just fear it won't be enough unless Connor Hellebuck keeps doing Hellebuck-type things. You're already pushing him hard, so they're playing with fire. Coyotes, why? Why do you suddenly fall apart when you give us tantalizations of not being shit, then promptly going back to shit? You got Taylor Hall, it doesn't mean you have to try and win the draft lottery for his sake! This is what I get for having hope in you, isn't it? Please stop. The teams I didn't mention are either sellers with varying degrees of success or teams I hate for relentless choking. San Jose, I'm looking right at you. Way to waste Jumbo Joe's career.
James Samsonov, who is deep in his net on the sharp angle shot. Panarin, up the middle, Sabanajan. He goes to the net. He scores! He scores! The Rangers win! Mika Sabanajan with five!